Today in the news, AMD's got some more Horizons, Intel is vulnerable again, and find out which gamer you are. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Before we start, let me just give a big thanks to our sponsor, Memory Express. They're based here in Canada and offer a complete price beat guarantee, not to mention their stores, which are a great place to try out all the newest peripherals for yourself before you buy them. Check out their online shop in the link down below. Let's get started with AMD, as usual. It looks like right after Computex, AMD will have some more to show at E3. Their next Horizon gaming event will be on June 10th and will definitely give us some more information on their 7-nanometer products. This might mean that we'll get a CES-like tease for Navi at Computex and the full reveal at E3. This is not completely new for AMD. They have used E3 before to announce some GPUs. The Fury X, for example, was unveiled at E3, and so was the RX 470 and 460. Now, why do I think it's going to be Navi at E3? Well, they already teased Ryzen 3000 at CES earlier this year, so a full reveal would be ideal for Computex. They might show extra benchmarks or talk about it a little more, but I don't think that they would do two teases for the same product. Historically, AMD has also never revealed a CPU at E3. If we look at their latest post, the 7 in Horizon means their presentation will have a focus on 7-nanometer gaming products, aka Navi. This will be an AMD-exclusive event, meaning they won't be splitting the stage with any other companies, so they're going to need a lot to pack that probably 1-hour-long event. At the same time, they might split the Navi releases, meaning that we'll have mid-tier Navi at Computex and lower-end ones at E3. We're probably going to have some info on Stadia 2, heck, AMD might even invite PlayStation on stage since they won't have their own E3 event. Right now, it's all speculations. All we know is that AMD has a full presentation for us at E3. Then we have Intel with yet another vulnerability. This one is once again a speculative execution leak, and it's called MDS, or microarchitectural data sampling. The only difference this time is that instead of leaking from cache, it leaks from various buffers within the processor. Just like Meltdown, this seems to be an Intel-specific problem, and both AMD and ARM processors are unaffected. While it seems like Intel is getting hit with new vulnerabilities every month, at least they're working quick to fix them as fast as possible. A microcode update rolled out today for Sandy Bridge and newer core processors, and the 8th and 9th gen CPUs apparently already have a fix on it on the hardware level. Hopefully, Intel also worked on fixing Spectre on their upcoming Comet Lake processors, because AMD definitely put the work into fixing it for Zen 2. Moving on, it looks like HP is getting creative with their latest Omen laptop. The Omen X2S is a 15-inch portable with a second display right above the keyboard. The tiny display is 6 inches with 1080 resolution, and it has some pretty cool features. You can send the focused window directly to that display by using a dedicated key, or you can crop a section of the main display into the smaller one. This could be useful when you're playing a game with a mini-map so you can blow it up, or you can zoom into the crosshair and get a zoomed in view for more clicks on foreheads. The CPU also comes with pre-applied liquid thermal paste, which is pretty cool. Is that screen going to be useful? Maybe a little, but personally, I don't like to look at screens on an angle, so this is a no for me. Maybe on the next one, they could allow some form of tilt. I mean, the 15-inch display is placed quite high, and they would have room for a little bit of a hinge there. Lastly, we have a new way of classifying us gamers. A games and analytics firm called Nuzu decided to create new categories to better represent the community. Instead of casual and hardcore gamers, we now have 8 different ways of ranking ourselves. You can be a time filler gamer, a backseat viewer, a popcorn gamer, a hardware enthusiast, a conventional player, a cloud gamer, an all-arounder, or the ultimate gamer. I took the quiz online and it looks like I'm in the hardware enthusiast category. I'll leave a link down below if you want to take the quiz and let me know what you got down in the comments. I mean, it's hard to categorize what an actual hardcore gamer is these days. Is it your gear that determines your level of hardcoreness or how much you play? Is playing PUBG on your phone 30 hours a week more hardcore than playing it on your PC for 15 hours a week? What do you guys think? Anyways, guys, that concludes it for today. Hopefully you've enjoyed. If you have any questions, leave them down below. Don't forget to check out Memory Express, link also down below. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video right here. To subscribe to the channel, it would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, and I'll see you guys on the next one.